I want to get now to the epicenter of all this, and that is Minneapolis, where there is a curfew in effect. Protesters are still out on the streets tonight. And there you see our Sara Sidner, who has been on the ground there. Sara, take it away. Go on. What are you seeing?
All right. So we are an hour and 12 minutes past curfew. And right now, the protesters rule the streets. The National Guard, nowhere to be seen. The state police, nowhere to be seen. The local police, nowhere to be seen. The sheriff's department, nowhere to be seen. The protesters are the ones that feel like these streets are their streets, which you will hear people chant. And they have been walking. The third precinct, by the way, is down that way, about 2 miles. We are 2 miles past where people have been for several days now as we've watched this unfold. And now we are 2 miles past that. You can see a fire going on there. That is cars that are on fire. Protesters here. And of course, there's an explosion because there is gas and there are all kinds of things inside of these cars. But I'm going to take you past the fires because you've been seeing fires all along and show you what's happening in these streets. These cars that you're seeing behind us, those are folks who are in support of more arrests of police officers in the case of George Floyd. They have been riding up and down, doing whatever they pleased in these streets, and there is no police presence whatsoever at this time. Very similar to yesterday in the sense that we saw no police after the third precinct caught fire. Today, what is incredible that I have never seen in covering dozens of protests across my career and across the world, I have never seen police disappear. And I'm talking about the National Guard. They told everyone from the state police, they made a huge announcement saying, you are in violation of an order to disperse because there was a curfew at 8. It is as if there was no curfew ordered at this time. Protesters have taken over the streets here. I'm on East Lake Street and now Park Avenue South here in Minneapolis. And almost every single one of these buildings that we're walking past has some damage or is boarded up. To my left over there, the Park Lake Car Wash, you can see the glass blown out there. And I'm going to pull us out of the road a little bit. You can see glass blown out in many different places here. But we are so far from where we were reporting yesterday, which was really sort of in the very close to where George Floyd ended up having a knee in his neck and losing his life.
Well, that really
means...
We're
way past that, and folks are just walking, trying to find the line.
That means a lot, Sara, considering the considerable reporting that you have done all across the world. As I mentioned last night, a decorated war correspondent, and here you are saying that you have not seen a situation like this where there is no law enforcement, especially on a street or streets of the United States in a major city in the United States of America. I want you to stand by. We'll get back to you, Sara. Let's get to CNN's Miguel Marquez. He is also in Minneapolis for us with a large group who are protesting and walking the street there. We understand that you have been talking and to some of these folks tonight. What are you seeing and what are you hearing from them, Miguel?
First thing I want to make perfectly clear, this has been almost entirely peaceful. In fact, completely peaceful. There have been a couple of individuals who have been slain for graffiti, but you also have many people, when they see it happening, when they see people attacking buildings, they will stop them. The entire crowd jumps on them and starts going after them. I want to show you where we are. This is 35 West. This is the freeway. This is the southbound lane. This crowd has grown. When we started off, it was maybe under 1,000. It looks like it's well over 1,000 people at this point. There are people from across the spectrum here. Young, old, boyfriends, girlfriends, white, black. People angry at what they see. It's not entirely clear where we're going. We're probably going off the freeway now, it looks like. But incredibly respectful. Also here, we haven't seen the police except to block off some of the streets so that they can pass peacefully. Look at how big this crowd is. It goes all the way back to the next exit. They blocked off traffic. It was a little worrisome to see this many people coming out here.
Don't tell me to get
Well, unfortunately, Miguel, as you know, As you know, this happens. You've covered that. People get into the camera and they say things that they shouldn't say, but we will continue and go on. What else are you seeing, Miguel?
They think that they're making a statement. There are some fireworks going off in different locations. It is a little worrisome that when they came on the streets, on the freeway, there were a lot of cars moving very, very rapidly. The police did not shut down the freeway. We've seen that in other cities where, in Baltimore and in New York, that the police will back off, shut down freeways, shut down streets, because the last thing they want is an incident where people get killed in one of these protests because a car went through them or they had an issue.
Hey, Miguel, where did this start? Where did this protest start?
This is the message.
Are we next?
Where did this protest start and how far are they traveling?
This started right at the base of the Viking Stadium. It was maybe 800, maybe 1,000 people strong. It has grown since then. They've marched all over downtown, sort of an act of defiance throughout the curfew. We're well into the curfew at this point. And the police have backed off, trying to stop traffic from going near them. They did not do anything to stop traffic when they came onto the freeway here.
And
so they are still.
And you are right when you're talking about the message. Am I next? As the poster reads, "Am I next?" That's what many people in this country are concerned about.
This is exactly what the message that people are talking about here. You know, am I next? The sense of injustice, the sense of anger at how difficult it is to be a black man in America right now. But this is not just black people protesting here in Minneapolis tonight. It is people across the spectrum. And it is amazing to see the number of people on this freeway shutting it down right now. It's stunning. And when they issued that curfew today, with the mayor and then the governor issuing a curfew for both Minneapolis and St. Paul, and the number of the National Guard, state troopers or state patrol that was out, and police, it seemed very clear that they were not going, there was going to be a zero tolerance policy. But clearly, they are going to allow people to protest peacefully, and that's what is happening here tonight. They may be angry, they may be screaming at our camera, but I'd rather have them doing that than burning things down and looting. And they're on top of it. When somebody starts doing something, they go after them, make them stop, and make them move on. So it's an interesting dynamic that's playing out here. I think people here have even been shocked by the power that they have brought to bear here. Don?
And right you are. It's better that they yell at the camera than destroy property. Miguel Marquez, well said.